That's recording now.
I'll just...
Oh, hang on, turn it that way.
Oh, yeah.
Hold it, yeah, hold it.
Yeah.
And just can swing it around.
But just hold it steady, because it holds for a long time.
Yeah.
So we can continue now. So we can go.
Lepe.
Eu nu mai tată, cum îți cântam de pierde te are pame de omica. Că te uite la animale, iar nu tu nu mi-o tău tată în fare. Că mă ați uita mă mai uita pe mine, n-am mai acum, am mai e tău cum mai aia mea, că mea. E te mama e nana, era până, e te tău cătorită. Kini ramato to kununga chuba to tomato leo faka mwe mi chi faka betai o kaitu manaki tanga e fi nei ma to mai ona raki muri tai no mai raki te ne ho kai no e ki nei ma to ke fakange mai to kai to aro ga no ho piru mi ma to i na wa ka to a ko e ano ra te ma mai e to to ko mai ai ane a ke nei a
ai
E te mazo I te
ami
Thank you. hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we have forgiven our trespasses against thee. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Amen.
Kia ora, welcome to today. I'm Hoani Kahaki Mano. I'm from Te Araroa, Rangitukea, and Tikitiki. I've come here to celebrate this moment in time for the chief Hori Tikuri. We've had the hui at Tahege Marae, and we're marking this in history as a point of settlement of British Royal Navy in Whirinaki, Russell and Busby, as pertaining to the Treaty of Waitangi signing here of the 75 or so chiefs as origination from Admiralty and this flag that the King has given us, King William IV, to mark our connection to Britain directly here in the Hokianga Harbour as a first port of call in anything legal connected to a native court, which is in Tahiti, that we have marked down in history as the native magistrate court opening directly to Edinburgh Magistrate Court and Westminster Magistrate Court. So I'm saying, as my Wānoa family and the Rogan family, Dick Rogan, Tika Rogan, and Ōraiti Wānoa on the Marangaroa, blocks at Te Araroa, was responsible with these native land titles in the Rangitukia Magistrate Court, connected to Tahege Native Magistrate Court and connected to Okeato Native Magistrate Court in Russell, Bay of Islands, or better known as Russell, township of the Royal British Navy. Entrance from here in the Hokianga Harbour first, and then over to Okeato to set up the Magistrate Court there. They had difficulty in Honeheke with cutting their flag down, and so they shifted to Awaroa Magistrate Court in Helenville, where Rogan married the Manukau family, and John Rogan, the grandfather of Mohi Temati Manukau IV. So I have all his history, which led me to investigate his history, my own history with Rogan, of Rogan judges married into my family at East Coast and married into the Manukau family, John Rogan, joined together. That's why I'm here as a native land commissioner to verify the records of Hori Tikuri as being a prominent chief of Ngāpuhi. And with the Ngāpuhi district in Kaikohe, linked in a 360 degree area. And I'm invited with Morris Baker to all the descendants of Hori Tikuri to come to the Hui. So from that, we have made law with this in mind, the first arrival of the British settlers, in particular the Russell family, Moira Hoffman Russell, a friend of mine in Rotorua, and her family Russell were here in the Whirinaki lower area of the land in settlement with Busby. So I have her to witness for me her side of the British arrivals here and Rāwani, and the port and here where the treaty was signed. So we are putting this record straight, that the memorial of Hori Tikuri is positioned on the top of the maunga, above the marae, as being the highest point lookout from as far as I could see, and I say this, that his territory is Napoli and joined to up north and right down to Taupo is that northern province of called Auckland with these magistrates' courts inside it that I've just mentioned, and with Te Rau Waikato Whare Here Here Manukau, paramount chief, and also Hongi Heka, paramount chief from north at Te Huperiki Kamarai, have opened up the native court there and opened up the Okiato native court and took that over to the Waitangi Marae and opened inside the Marae with Kingi Taurua, Uri Taita and Hohepa Epiha as a native magistrate court in its original form, with the ship of Admiralty on the dry land as being the highest court in our country and projected out to the world with this flag to travel the four corners of the earth with an 8-point star of St. Patrick inside this jurisdiction of law that we are putting on the record today from this marae, this church, and also I have scribed the marks, the lines to line up on top of the hill with a video to show the church here and where the tree was signed, a point marking that to the Ratana Church where Morris is looking after the land, and I'm staying there presently as the Ratana, T.W. Ratana, with his plaque on top of the hill in the Urupa, identified the Urupa as where the positioning of mana lies in Ngāpuhi, as to the mana lying in Apiku with Lepalepa Manukau. On a book, these final books here, we're listening today with Lepalepa and Rogan, signed in a deed titled Receipt, as proof that there was a connection between us and Britain, two-party private contract, and anything else was third party. So I'm identifying the Manukau title as being customary before it got cut up, and with the survey SO number on the titles, on the big blocks, and with Referefa there and Hori to here, in this area, is no different in its authority and its certificate to all those land blocks inside the New South Wales and the New Zealand government, Crown, Queen Victoria and Queen Elizabeth, third party contract here today. I'm putting on the record as being this is where the Treaty of Waitangi was signed, for those documents on the Queen, Victoria and Queen Elizabeth's side in Waitangi Marae and Titi Marae, has been secondary to this piece of land here, as one piece of land to all the rest of the pieces of land of New Zealand, and those two chiefs as two prominent chiefs, one Moriori, Manukau title, and one Ngāpuhi Tahiti Hukana title. That's going to Hongi Heka and Te Rau Waikato Wharehere Here Manukau on the stamps we have here to authenticate these documents with a joining of the two today here. And we will authenticate with Manahi Parapara Mauhini as being a direct descendant of Manukau, Te Rau Waikato Wharehere Here Manukau, with King George, 1820 to 1830 period of a private contract that set the pattern off to lock these lands as a blueprint for the rest of the native countries in the world in that period of time, and locked with King William IV and Reperepa Manukau on this contract here in our time, in our period of commerce, and the King of Commerce or the King of the Sea. And this flag here you see as being the contract of 1834, the 15th of March 1834, Okeaka Native Magistrate Court in Russell, where that British title was stamped into history here, has been overlooked, and the New South Wales took over from there as being secondary on the 1835 Declaration of Independence and leading to the 1840 treaty signed here. So the authority, as far as I'm concerned, as a native land commissioner, is to verify that this is the piece of land that the Treaty of Waitangi was signed by the 75 or so chiefs to authenticate these documents back to them and back to Hori Te Huri on the top of the hill as a paramount chief with the same likeness of documents as Referefa Manukau of Afiku in the south of Manukau Harbour. That's Manukau Marae. It was changed to Tahuna Marae by the Minhere family. I've got all that history on record and on video in the time of Mohi Manukau. In the 6 years I spent with him identifying his title area of his paramount chief, Referefa Manukau, and Te Reo Waikato Wharekerehe Manukau. Te Reo Waikato came from Cambridge, or Manukau to the mountain, as being the first contact to Cambridge University in Britain, where he and Hongiheka went to learn English, and Hongiheka was responsible for the security of the investment interests of this flag and its titles to commerce, trade in the sea around the whole world, with our native title locked in the contract so that it would not be pirated. This is a pirate flag to keep pirates out. Mm-hmm. And so we are still in a contract today, and we are just reasserting our sovereign powers and our authority of the king. I'm acting as surrogate king, William IV, for this flag, speak for the king, and until there's a king put into Westminster. Now, I'm saying this for the record that King Ernest Augustus, the fifth, is the reigning monarch of Britain, UK, Hanover, and Aotea, New Zealand, Pacific Islands. As far as we're concerned, we have done that in Te Kī Marae and Waitangi Marae. Put him as our oath of office, though he's not there. He has been the only king that's incumbent of the king-to-king title. In sailor law forbids women from succeeding. But the Queen has her own title. She has gone to EU Parliament and has abandoned ship and left her Maori people afloat to sort themselves out. So this is the way to sort the Maori side of the 1835 flag, of the other half of this flag, and the 1840 treaty, which we can now report to Britain from here with the blessings of this church and our minister, Manahi, Parapara Mohini, to officiate and authenticate these documents before I go to Westminster with Morris or Lobo, as his name is called, Morris Pekka or Pekka, and his wife, Mary Ann. To assist myself and Manahi to take this discovery of home back to identify ourselves and the flag. And they will recognize their British settlement here as authentic to all native countries in the world. And we are just putting the record straight for Ngāpuhi, because they went to get help from Britain. But it's turned the other way into the Queen and the Rothschild banks took it, and it went that way. So we're putting it back into the King's Bench Court, which we operate now at the moment. Inside Tahiti Marae is now a native magistrate court, Britain direct. So with that, I just want to say from our Rangitukia area, one more final point is that the St. Mary's Church is 1831, where the births, deaths, and marriages of the British titles were put together as a blueprint for all the other births, deaths, and marriages certificates in the world through King William IV in New York on the stock exchange. So I'll just briefly say that that's where it came from on Marlene Rocks and the Rahui Marae, Tiki Tiki, and the Rangitukia Native Magistrate Court was a schoolhouse there where these documents were signed with Clendon, James Reddy Clendon, captain of his Admiralty ship, British ship, when signed here at Okeaka Native Magistrate Court in the Auckland provincial area of, described from north Te Rere Wairua or Cape Reinga down to south of Taupo in a line east to west. All of that area was the province of Auckland at this time these contracts were made. So that's the part of the birth certificates and the fashioning of titles and instruments over the land. The land is still there, but I'm talking about documents that created the wealth that they enjoy and that we have not yet. But we are still two-party contract with the British direct, and everything else is third party. I'm saying here, for the record, that the mana lies here on this piece of land. Te Tihi Marae and Waitangi Marae is a third party with a New South Wales and New Zealand government crown, and we are the crown of Britain today and on the record, for the record. And so I'm saying the 8-point star on the flag of St. Patrick comes from Belfast in Northern Ireland, Protestant Church. My Rogan's family comes from there as judges here in Awaroa Native Court in Helensville, and Mohi Te Mati Manukau, where I started research with his papa, and then ended up on my own at home at the East Cape. Those instruments and the St. Patrick's Church in Belfast, Downpatrick Village County, is what formed the birth, death, marriage certificates and all the other certificates to collect the royal revenue for these things from the councils, and as fashion as rates and administrative costs and everything of prize positions comes under this 8-point star. You'll see John Key wearing it here just recently, and I'm wearing it on my hair, and anybody else that's a sheriff in these courts have the authority. It's for you people watching around the world to decide which is authentic. And I'm saying we're going back to Britain to take our authentic findings today. After today, we have a meeting in Ngawakamarae in Auckland Epsom, where the Manukau title is put inside that marae to this marae here, enjoying Ngāpui with the Moriori and the Tahiti, and they are one. That's the way to bring all the people together, is to identify who we are and where we come from. And that includes Pākehā and everybody. Once and for all, we'll put the history in its right place where it should be, and it should turn out, as far as I'm concerned, it should turn out exactly right. So with that, I'm saying that with those St. Mary's Church, St. Patrick's Church, and our King, with the flag he gave us to protect that business, and it goes on, it's not cut. We have to go to Britain to either extend it or replace the trustees, the Queen, and Prince Andrew, and the King and Queen of Spain. The King has died of Spain and left the Queen of Spain, and their son, Philippe, King Philippe, took over from his father, but not the trust. The trust belongs to us, the Queen Victoria Trust, 1848, still belongs to us. So we have to identify ourselves with any sort of claim to that. So I'm just saying the book here is a magistrate court portable to be on any marae in the world, or any marae in New Zealand, Pacific Islands, and in any court in the world is tax precedence, because it's a king's court, and the king has put all these laws in fashion and designed all the acts of commerce and of everything that has built this country to where it is. with all its buildings, instructions, roads, and everything, has come out of this court. We have instructions here, the Acts of King William IV, 1832 to 1837, to match the flag. And that's all we had to do all these years. We're now going to enforce those laws into law here and through the world where the flag went. So that's all I want to say today. And I'll leave the rest of the final word to Apokolo, of the Rapa Church, and he has all the hallmarks of T.W. Ratana in this area where all this was going on at the same time as the arrival of the Methodist Church, where the Ratana Church originated. And at this time of holding, and through that time of Ravika, his father, is buried down below on the hill, on the flat behind, where Morris and I sat with Marianne inside the church. He has occupied the church and the land, and he has recovered all the land back that he has got, at least 10 of them, and my job is to put them back further, remove the alien title and put it back into the deed title, where it came from in the first place to Britain, and no more mortgages, no more debts, and remove it from the property as a land commissioner, a native land commissioner. That's my job on the Rogan judge side, on the Rogan document side, and on the Cosgrove's lawyer side. The law of the Cosgrove's married my wife was at East Coast, and so that's, you'll see me talking somewhat like a judge and somewhat like a lawyer. In fact, that's what I do. There's my part of the blood in me, and the red brown part is Tahiti Moai from East Island, Te Pito, the birth of the world on East Island to Te Pito at the East Gate on our Marae Island blocks where this magistrate court was. That is why the Rogan married the Wairoa and married the Manukau, for that reason of these documents of two families to make it get this far. So with that manahi, I just wanted to acknowledge that Rāmeka was living and practicing the church with the Wesleyan Church in Whirinaki with the Russell family. My good friend Moira Hoffman, German, Russell, English, is living here at that time in Rowan and in that very year. And the Russell is the Navy families, one of the Navy families, went to Russell. That's her name in Russell. And she'll verify her side of these prophetic documents at any stage to put the record right of her arrival, of her British people. And so that's all I want to say today. It's all yours from now, Manahi. Thank you for the opportunity to witness with you today.
Sure. Te mātātou katoa, uroa nei koutou I ngā kōrero whakahirahira o tātou rangatira, tā mai nei I rupu I a tamaki makau. Me ko hāre atu te te wairua, te rungi atu koutou, Āku whakakapi tēnei wā o te whakamuimiti, nā ka tukuratu me hiana kaito I te tū I te kōrero. Me kāre rāne, tā ko kapi e tō tātou. Me rā tō tātou ngā koi atrā, e tautuko me nā kōrero I tēnei rā, ko Mate Māre. Oh.